đã đến với chuỗi vlog về ngành nail cùng với T-Spa. Hôm nay có khách mời đặc biệt, cô Kristen là Vice President của chuỗi nhà băng tại BB&T Houston, Texas. Cảm ơn quý anh chị đã luôn theo dõi và đồng hành cùng với T-Spa. Video này, thực ra công ty T-Spa có rất nhiều quý anh chị nói được rất là giỏi tiếng Anh. Nhưng mà Thảo thì cũng không có giỏi mấy về tiếng Anh, cũng broken English. Nhưng mà Thảo vẫn mong muốn là mình có thể truyền cảm hứng cho quý anh chị tự tin giao tiếp với những người ở đây. Tại vì họ ở đây để mà giúp đỡ chúng ta, để help chúng ta, chứ không có adjust cái giọng của mình. Cho nên là dù mình có nói cái giọng mình hơi khó nghe thì họ vẫn luôn cố gắng giúp đỡ mình. Ok, Kristen, I try to tell my audience, like, in T-Spa we have so many people speak really good English, like Mr. Lee or Mr. Damon, but actually, I would profit English, but I think every people in the bank, special banker, they here to help, not a judge, right? So, Kristen say, don't worry, Thảo, she here to listen. So, I'm really, really appreciate you spend time to, I know you're busy, but you try your best to stay here and spend time with us to share a lot good information for my audience, special Vietnamese community in nail industry. Thank you, Kristen.
Thank you, Thảo. Thank you so much for having me and giving me this opportunity to come and talk to your audience. You guys are so special to me, and I'm just so happy to be able to be here and just share a little bit about our bank today. So thank you very much.
And we know you're a Vive resident, but can you explain people exactly like the role,
yes,
your role in the bank?
Yeah, so I do have a vice president title. My job is actually, I'm called a commercial relationship manager. So I am the primary point of contact for business owners like yourself.
Thank you.
And it's my job to advocate for my clients to the bank and help them get access to all of the resources that they need inside of the institution. It's my job to effectively be their quarterback, like in a football game. Whenever you have a financial need, you throw me the ball and I throw it to the right person that can help you find the solution for whatever it is that you need to accomplish. So that is my job, is to be an advocate for my clients and help them accomplish their financial goals.
Yeah, yeah. So when you work with in Texas, you have a chance to work a lot with Vietnamese business owner. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes.
So
I've been fortunate to have a lot of relationships in the Vietnamese community, and you've been very helpful with that as
well. Yeah, Vietnamese community kind of big and bigger in Houston. They big and they do a lot of things about the business, especially nail salon owner.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we know a lot of bank here in Houston, and it's on a big bank.
Yeah.
So what should someone to BB&T over order?
Yeah, that's a good question. And I think sort of what going back to what I was saying a minute ago is that you need a partner in your business. There are lots of banks. You can walk out your front door and you can find a bank on your corner.
Yes.
And I'm sure that they have a credit card and they probably have a checking account that they can offer you.
Right.
But I think at the end of the day, it comes down to the relationship that you have with your banker and how you're working together to accomplish your financial goals. I think it's so critical that you have a partner in your relationship. And like we said, Tao, with the merger, we're a really large bank now. We're the sixth largest bank in the state.
Yeah, six.
But all of our decisions are made on a local level. So every credit decision that I get to be involved with, I work with a local credit officer to help me to make those decisions. So we're not, you know, going by some big bank standard. We're still operating like a very close regional bank. And we're as close to our clients as we ever could be. So I think that the relationship is just what is so critical. And what I hear from my clients is very important, is that they want a person who understands their business and can take their request to the bank to help them to grow their business and take it to the next level.
Thank you, Kristen. So like, what did you say? So I understand like, this is a big bank. It's a sixth big bank of the United States.
Yes, ma'am.
Right, but every decision they based on local decision.
Yes, ma'am.
So it will be fast, right?
Yeah.
The rate, the credit, everything will be fast. It's not like big bank and you come and you have to wait about a week or month to get approved or not, but BB&T get quick, right? So in my case, in my business work with BB&T, so I want to share, this is really, really good. I think it's a trick, right? Because like when you got a credit line or the loan, you actually with me, you don't need to go to big bank, because BB&T big, but they knew in pesos. So they just come to the pesos, they try to get everything really fast, better rate, high credit line they can give for the client. So everything, I think the customer service about how fast, how convenient they do, I really, really enjoy when I work with BB&T. So I have a lot of offer from other banks.
Yes, ma'am.
But when I work with BB&T, they do the best because they knew they have to do the best so they can get more clients. That's really good thing when we think about if we got the loan from other banks, we can think about BB&T first because good rate. That's
yeah.
a good thing. Really
yeah.
good rate. So other questions we talk about in general about BB&T,
yeah.
how good BB&T can offer to the clients. Now, to the specific name industry.
Yes.
If my customer they want to borrow, the customer will want to borrow the money
yes.
from the BB&T
yeah.
to open a nail salon. So
yeah.
what is specific requirement will the bank need?
Yeah. So I think if you're gonna open up a new nail salon, something that's going to be any new business really, it's gonna
yeah.
be very important. It's going to be really telling your story very well
yeah.
And being able to articulate what your background is and how much experience that you have in that industry.
Oh.
Because it's very important that we understand that you didn't just wake up and decide to open up a nail salon. You have experience doing this. You understand what the mechanics are going to be to run a business. And that you have a good team behind you to help you make that business successful. So I think the first thing is being able to tell your story and being able to articulate that to your bank.
Yeah.
And then having your financials together. Obviously, you know, every decision that we make, it has a financial backing. And so we need to understand what your historical financial picture looks like. So looking at your tax returns and your financial picture. And if you're not ready yet, I think it's a good thing to go and have a conversation with your banker and sit down with them and say, this is my particular picture. And
yeah.
like I've shared with you, this is not a cookie cutter. It's not one size fits all. Everyone's
yeah.
needs are different. Every business is different. But I think it's really important that first you have a good understanding of what it takes to run your nail salon or any business that you're going to open up. You know how much money it's going to take to make that happen. And you have a good plan to accomplish those goals. And that would be the very fundamental piece of getting your presentation ready for your banker. And then from there, having a discussion of how do we really make this happen.
Perfect. That's really good. So when we plan to have open a new nail salon,
mm-hmm.
When we just start from like nail technician, but we plan we want to open a new salon, so we can talk to the banker what we want.
Yeah.
How big the nail salon we think we can do, where we lease, how much money we can loan, and your statement to show them the plan, the finance, so they can go ahead and do it. You know us about long time, so you know Vietnamese people love saving. We
yes.
love saving too.
Yes.
When we just sell something and we have about a little bit money and we saving for, not just saving for the life or something we cannot predict, we saving for the kid also.
Absolutely.
So you think this is, the bank is a good choice for us to saving the money?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. We actually offer a financial foundations program where we actually teach people. This is something that we should probably talk about too, but
yeah,
we actually can offer it to our clients' employees as well. And so we do outline the importance of savings in that program. As a relationship manager who works with a credit officer, one of the conversations that comes up a lot is financial flexibility.
Yeah.
Financial flexibility means how much money do you have accessible to you? So that would be your liquidity. So I think saving is so critical, and it's so important to have that cushion and have that safety net,
mm-hmm.
to your point, not only just for now and not only
yeah.
just for that next business, but for your future generations.
Right.
So we certainly understand that that is something that is very important. And for our customers that are good savers, we're absolutely, you know, more, I don't want to say more favorable, that's not the right word, but I think that we can put a lot more comfort in those relationships
right.
because we understand that, let's take COVID for example.
Right.
those businesses and those business owners that had financial flexibility,
yes,
that had liquidity, had cash, they were able to weather that storm and still keep their business open.
Mm-hmm.
Those companies and those individuals that did not have that financial flexibility,
mm-hmm,
a lot of them ended up shutting their doors.
Right.
And so that's a very, very sad picture. So we always just say, you just don't know what you're going to expect.
Yeah.
And having those right tools in place is very important. Having, you know, working capital lines of credit, commercial loans, all that is good. But at the end of the day, you have to make sure you have a safety net.
Yeah. So saving is like foundation.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. So when we have extra, we can invest, but we need to save in something we don't know.
Yeah.
We can predict. So like about investment, like now the market, respect market in Texas, special Houston, so hot.
Yeah.
A lot of friends, a lot of Vietnamese friends, a lot of Vietnamese community, they kind of trendy, they invest,
yeah,
on buy the house. So I look at the bank interest rate and it's really kind of low.
Yeah.
Is that a good time to buy a house to invest right now?
So it's a good question. And I think that this is a very personal choice.
Right? Yeah,
so
right.
Again, everyone's situation is different. But to your point, rates are very low right now. Personally, I just bought a house last September and I got a very good rate for my 30-year mortgage. So we do have a large volume of clients that are applying to refinance loans,
yeah,
that are purchasing new properties. Commercial real estate loans are still very attractive. So we have a lot of activity in the commercial bank right now, financing both commercial properties, other large purchases like equipment to take advantage of those low interest rates. And there's some tax benefits to that too. Now, I'm not licensed to give you tax advice, so talk to your tax person. But there's some really great incentives out there for business owners who are looking to grow their business and,
yeah,
use bank money to do it. And to your point, the rates are really attractive right now.
So what are the rate right now BB&T can offer, the lowest one?
You can't put me on the spot like that, Tal.
So what
is
the round rate?
So it is case by
case,
right? And it depends on the product, right? So there's a lot that goes
into it. It's a sensitive question.
Not necessarily. It's just that there is a lot that goes into interest rates.
Yeah.
So the way I always try to explain it is that your interest rate on any loan you get approved for is tied to the risk associated with it.
Yeah.
So an interest rate on a home loan is going to be much lower than, say, an unsecured line of credit, right? Because you have collateral here and you don't have collateral here. Someone that has 20 years of experience is going to get a better rate than someone has 2 years of experience because they're just very different. So when you go and you talk about rate, it's kind of like when you look at insurance, right? If you've had an accident before, your rates are higher, right?
So
if your credit profile is a little riskier because maybe, you know, you had, 5 years ago you had a missed payment, you know, who knows what it is, but maybe that's going to drive your rate to be a little higher than somebody that's going to be well qualified. So, but I will say that, to answer your question, the rates are very favorable right now, and it's a really good time if you're going to lock in a rate for a 5-year, 10-year loan for any commercial transaction. This is a great time to take advantage of it.
Yeah, right. So, like, simple thing, like, if we open the new salon already, and we think about opening the second one, so our experience and our rate will be better, like we can open a new one.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's just like simple, like.
Absolutely, and another thing with us that plays into this is the relationship.
Oh, relationship.
Absolutely.
So BB&T, right, everything, one of the things we rate relationship.
Absolutely.
Yeah, the longer we go, the better thing we can have, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely, so we are not, as we talked about earlier, we're not a transactional bank. We have, you know, loans and credit cards. We can certainly do transactions all day long, but at the end of the day, we really are looking to build relationships with our clients. And the way that we price our loans and we offer new credit to our customers is based on the relationship. So I'm able to be more flexible with customers like you that are willing to have bank accounts and are willing to open up, you know, corporate cards and do real estate loans and equipment financing. We are going to always be able to be more flexible with our customers that want to be able to do more business with us. And ultimately, our goal is really to help our customers take their business to that next level by having
awesome.
That relationship.
Yeah.
With you.
Thank you, Kristen, for coming and sharing really, really beautiful information. So, Vietnamese community, special in Texas, they know more about BB&T, who they are, and what special they are.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you so much. If my audience have any question, they can inbox us so we can transfer to you. Or you guys can contact BB&T anytime.
Absolutely.
BB&T have more than 20 locations in Houston, Texas.
At least.
At least more than that.
Yeah.
Thank you, Tristan, for coming. Hopefully we can come up and get another video on my vlog, right?
I would love to do it, and I'm happy to always bring in new partners for you to ask different questions to anytime, and it's always a pleasure to visit your beautiful space here.
Thank you, Tristan. Cảm ơn quý anh chị đã theo dõi chuỗi vlog cùng với T-Spa. Xin hẹn gặp lại quý anh chị trong những video lần sau.